It's the 2K Sports Pregame Show, sponsored by Kia.
Hello again, everybody. I'm Ernie Johnson. Welcome to 2K Sports. We're already getting the feel for this new NBA season. Taking it all in with me, Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. And on tap tonight, it's the Sacramento Kings going up against the New Orleans Pelicans. New Orleans comes into this one following a loss to Golden State. That game was high scoring. Tonight, they'll need to be better defensively. A chance to see one of the purest scorers in the league tonight. Rudy Gay's in action. He can make it look so easy at times, Kenny.
Yeah, he makes it look easy. You know, the one thing about him, he mixes his game up pretty well. You know, he shoots his threes to keep the defenders honest. But he takes it to the rim just as much. But consistent scorer. I know Shaq loves him, from the start of his career.
Yeah, he's always been a guy you can count on. Ernie, Kenny, put up points. And what I really like about his game is he can handle the pressure of being the main scoring option.
That about does it for now. Tip off, fast approaching. We send it to Kevin Harlan.
Welcome, everyone, to this 2K Sports broadcast live from the capital city of California, Sacramento. This is Kevin Harlan. We've got Chris Webber and Greg Anthony with us. And from the sideline, we'll be hearing from David Aldridge. This game in Sacramento marks the start of a homestand for the Kings. Still early in the season, but the front office and coaching staff likes what they are seeing from this team so far. Better winning percentage than last year.
I mean, they're in the midst of a huge stretch right now, and I'm not sure if they can sustain it. But they ought to ride this momentum as long as they can.
And before we get going, let's hear from David Aldridge on the sideline. David?
Well, guys, Anthony Davis's ascent to stardom has been almost as quick as the physical growth that transforms his game. Davis said, going into my senior season in high school, I grew 7 inches in one summer. Every 2 to 3 weeks, I needed new clothes, new shoes. As I grew, it was like starting all over again. Kevin?
Thanks, DA. As I recall, he said that was a tough adjustment, but he's been ahead of the curve ever since. Well, we're still, Chris, early in the season. The pecking order's still working itself out. But as a player, what are you looking for to know that you're in for a big season, that you're going to be a pretty good team?
Well, chemistry in the locker room is so important. The season is going to bring some adversity sooner or later. So when you have that camaraderie and you're all pulling in the same direction, that really helps you to overcome the rough ride that you know you're going to have during the season.
That's an excellent point. And the starting lineup for the Pelicans, Davis and Isaac working together down low. Holiday and Evans are the one and the two. And it's Hill in at the small forward spot.
Oh, Collison has tremendous defensive chops. He really reads his man well and comes up with steals as a result.
And so it's the Kings getting on the board first. Back to Holiday. Ashik with a screen on Gay. The putback, the dive for the ball. Pass to Holiday. Ashik against Cousins. Outside Holiday. He kicks to Davis. Lets it go from the baseline and nails it.
I mean, look, he's just an instinctive guy. Helping his teammates generate some offense comes naturally to him.
Holiday against Collison. And now just over a minute played here in the first. He feeds it to Cousins. Stolen by Ashik. And oh, here we go with Hill. Nobody back.
Such a strong finisher on the fast break.
When he has the ball in his hands in transition, he always finishes strong, just like he did there.
Now, here's Collison. He had 13 points in the win against Toronto. Passes it to Cauley-Stein. From outside, off the mark.
Ooh, can't believe he missed that one. I thought for sure that was going in.
Davis dishes to Holiday. Pass to Osiek. Back to Holiday. Davis inside. He's covered by Gay. And the rejection by Cauley Stein. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Gay. About 2 minutes played here in the first quarter.
The shooters beware. Cauley Stein is very crafty in how he rises up to the block. So good at catching scores off guard with his wide reach.
Evans kicks to Davis. The basket good off the assist from Evans. Davis has got his second bucket.
Well, that's why they're in front. Aggressive play at both ends. Nicely done.
Collison the pass to Cousins. Collison gets a wide open look, gets a very good look, and converts.
The mid-range area of the floor is so important, and Collison knows how to shoot from there.
And Holiday kicks to Osiek. It's Evans on the wing. Here's Davis, and it's in off the backboard. Davis has got six.
Oh, he's gotten off to a superb start by shooting the ball extremely well from the field.
Get outside! He's open!
Right side, Collison. And it's a follow, penetrating Evans with some nice D.
Those are chances almost always you can rely on him to get you 2 points, but the D just enough to keep him out of rhythm. And when they've gone to him, he has come through big time. You got to keep getting him touches.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
Gay against Davis. Here's Cousins, and a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. And Chris, the one thing with Cousins is that he is a very strong free throw shooter.
And for his career, Cousins shoots over 70%, which is a big plus for a center. He has increased how frequently he gets to the line, so he's seeing more and more free throws as well. Many defenders don't even have an answer for him, other than just a foul.
And the first one at the line is good.
And just look, now with Cousins, we see him becoming that player everyone hoped he would become when he entered the league. It's strange to think he was taken fifth overall in his draft, given his skill set. You would think a lot of GMs would want that do-over.
And so DeMarcus Cousins nails both of them. And for Cousins, certainly he will end up being one of the best players in the league out of that 2010 draft.
He's one of the best big men in the game, and his skills on the court have never been questioned, but his antics on the court have been, and that's what drops his draft position. He can butt heads with his coach at times and doesn't hide any contention. This happened often enough in his career that he has to accept part of the blame for it.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
The Kings have had two chances at the line already, making them both. That free throw, no good. And for NBA teams, the hardest thing to do is to get superstar talent, obviously. The Pelicans have that in Anthony Davis. How, Greg, do you think they build around him?
Well, a big part of it is just him staying healthy. I mean, we all know this is the team that's had horrible luck in that regard. Now they're shaping personnel to fit the new coaching staff. A bit more shooting, more depth. I think that's going to be key.
And he's good on the second.
And Cousins is one of the best big men in the league who continues to get better over time.
Collison against Holiday. Count the basket. Holiday's got his first points of the game.
Just no resistance inside at all. They are feasting. This is a straight buffet.
It is. It's a big one. And load the plate. And pushing it up. Here's New Orleans. And that one, good. Holiday's got his second bucket of the night.
And great awareness to toss the ball ahead for the uncontested score.
The Kings trail by seven.
Set up.
Outside Collison. He dishes it to Gay. Kicks it to Cauley Stein. Back to Gay. Sacramento moving it around. A follow the pass to Cauley Stein. Clock at six. To the paint. Here's Cousins. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. And with the Kings, Chris, playing in a smaller market, and you know about that market well, they rarely get a chance to make big free agent signings. I mean, what's been the key?
Well, it's something that just isn't present in any other NBA city. The Kings are the only ticket in town and are loved by the city of Sacramento. The outreach and community interaction the Kings have is absolutely fantastic, and you can tell the players know how special a place it is to play.
And watching the Kings, Chris, you can't help but think back to their glory years back in the early 2000s when you played for them.
Well, I'm happy to be a part of that 2002 team. We set the franchise best for the team with 61 wins that year. You love the way that team played just because of how they played. Beautiful ball move.
And here's a follow. Following the three from Tyreke Evans.
That's the maturation of Cousins' game. Everyone knows he can score the ball, but he is starting to show great strides in his passing.
Outside Holiday. Front pass the arc. Offensive rebound. Aginsa. And he banks in the layup. Aginsa's got his first bucket of the night.
Really nice job to convert the putback opportunity there. I mean, he stayed with that play from start to finish. That's something we say about him a lot.
Now here's Collison. Cousins inside. Working on Aginsa. A follow, no good. New Orleans leading by nine. It's Evans on the wing. A chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark. Cauley Stein dishes to Gay. High post Cousins working on Aginsa. And Cousins kicks to Cauley Stein. A three from Gay. Tyreke Evans comes up with the rebound and the foul called on DeMarcus Cousins. That's his first foul and first time out of the game called for New Orleans.
And for the Pelicans, to me, one of the things that's kept them out of the upper echelon are really a couple things. It's been their struggles on the defensive end and injuries. I mean, this is a team that has the length and the athleticism, and that's an area where you knew they could make some improvement. So last season was a bit of a disappointment. And checking out some numbers here for Collison. Last season's performance for him. Last year averaged 14 points per game, 4 assists, and 2 rebounds. And, guys, he's making winning plays. It's as simple as that. Not a star player per se, but he makes his presence felt.
And for the Pelicans, great length in the front court. Greg, where do they need to get better defensively?
Kevin, I think the wing spots. That's where they really need a stopper. They had more offensively oriented players out there. And with the rise of the three ball, length and tenacity on the perimeter become so important.
Good point.
They were right up in his grill. Really gave him no breathing room to release that one clean.
Davis. Rebound by the Kings. This game coming on the heels of their win against Toronto.
And with the type of defense they played that day, they were able to cause a lot of mistakes.
Incredibly disruptive on that end of the floor. Got up in guys' shirts, jumped in the passing lane. It was wild.
And it's a completely new group on the floor for the Kings. New Orleans also making some changes. Quincy Pondexter, he's checked in for Solomon Hill. Heald comes in for Tyreke Evans. And Langston Galloway subbed in for Drew Holiday. Now, here's Kufis. He's coming off a 13-point game against the Raptors in Toronto.
And how about the way he really challenged shooters in that game, rejecting 3 shots and possibly changing numerous others.
Galloway with the bucket. And the Pelicans lead by 13.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint. Really aggressive play there, taking it to the rack against the big fella.
Awesome attack toward the basket right there. This young man stays on his grind, showing his true grit and finding a way to get that one to go.
Pondexter with it, covered by Barnes. There's the pass to Galloway. Outside, Davis. Galloway kicks to Davis. Heel. Up again. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
And no doubt they've come into this game with a really aggressive approach, just pounding the ball inside.
Well, they're really pushing their interior game right into the face of the D. And so far, the defense has no answer for it.
Terrence Jones has checked in for Alexis Agent. Here's Galloway. The dish to Jones. Knocked loose and stolen by Kufis. Lawson kicks to Caspi. Barnes outside to the wing right side. McLemore, the pass to Caspi. The rim-rattling two-handed jam.
Caspi's not just a scorer, but an incredible athlete as well who can throw it down with the best of them.
New Orleans leading by 11. Galloway kicks to Jones. Fires from the corner. Kufis grabs the miss.
Really surprised he clanked that one. He makes those on the regular.
Here's Lawson. And a miss there with a chance to cut the lead to single digits. Down low. And it's Jones. That time on the assist by Heald.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
Sacramento's gone 0-3 from three-point land. Nothing yet going outside. To the inside. Here's Caspi. That's basket number two with his third shot off to a fast 2-for-3.
And Caspi is just a nuisance to guard for many reasons, including his ability to get big down low and come away with the easy bucket.
They set the pick. Pondexter kicks to Davis. Here's Galloway. Lawson defending. Just four to shoot. New Orleans needs to get off a shot. Pondexter from outside. Doesn't go for him. Good D by Barnes. Here's Lawson. Second shot opportunity. A nice shot by Kufis.
Man, he's in attack mode, crashing the glass, then goes right back up with it.
Here's Galloway. Dishes it to Heald. Down low. And it's Davis with the jam.
You couldn't have dreamed of a much better start here than they've had today.
The beginning of this game has had their imprint all over.
And Anthony Davis last season signing a contract extension, the richest contract in NBA history at that point, $145 million. Over 5 years. He'd already become a superstar player. Now freed from the rookie scale, he's finally paid like it.
Now here's Barnes. 9 points last game.
And trailing here in the first, you'd like to see them be a little more aggressive on the offensive glass.
And again, it's Anthony Davis. Davis has got 12. You talk about the big contract for Davis. A lot of money for a young guy, but you don't much worry that he'll get his priorities, Greg, twisted.
A great point, Kevin. He's a team-first guy, all about winning, and he doesn't take it for granted. He didn't have all the hype growing up, but now he's living a dream, and he knows it. But he aspires to be great, and he's not settling for anything else.
Tries to keep it alive, and it's going to be out of bounds. The Pelicans will retain possession. And going out of bounds, last touch by Barnes. And let's take a look at the playmaking here. This chart with the assist totals split between the front court and the back court tonight for New Orleans.
And their guards are taking on the majority of the passing and assisting for the team. Just as you might expect, the bigs doing their part by getting to good spots inside and making themselves available.
Four on the shot clock. Here's Davis. They force the shot clock violation. Great team. Now that we have a chance, let's go to the 2K leaderboard and reveal last shot blockers. Fourth, Anthony Davis.
And shot blocking element of the game that I think he cares about the most. That's where he puts in that effort and energy.
Lawson dishes to McLemore. There's 48 left in the first quarter. Good work there as it goes.
Oh, you can't forget about the speed of McLemore. Uses it so well on his drives to the hoop.
Jones, no one around him. Bounces high off the rim and drops. Jones has got his second bucket.
And they've done the job on the offensive glass.
Wasson outside to the inside. Barnes. And it's Barnes slamming it down.
And if that doesn't get them fired up, guys, nothing will.
Greg, just what the doctor ordered, huh? Some high-flying annex to narrow the deficit.
Well, also a miscommunication on defense. No one rotates over. See ya.
Now, here's Davis. Stay up. He had a 30-point outing their last game against the Warriors in Oakland.
Oh, and the rebound is spectacular as well. He was in attack mode all night.
And how about the grasp they had on the game plan for this one?
Well, they really came in focused on executing what they wanted to. They imposed their will on the opposing team. They have been virtually perfect so far. Fading away in traffic, terrific body control allows him to square up.
Galloway. The offense coming free and easy as we wrap up the first quarter. Pelicans lead by 9. And the second quarter will get underway just after this short break. And one of the rising stars in the NBA is Anthony Davis. His offensive game is growing by leaps and bounds, and he talked about his area of focus.
A lot of face-up, you know, I like to do the one dribble pull-up. You like to do the one dribble fade back off one leg. I haven't got there yet, you know. But, you know, catching the ball at the elbow, you know, catching the ball at the nail.
Well, I tell you, you could be here an awfully long time if we're going to list all the different moves Anthony Davis with.
Yeah, the brow definitely has the full kit available to him. Tools a lot of guys don't learn to use till later in their careers, really, if at all.
And we welcome you back to start. The players had a chance to get hydrated with Gatorade and to be some great basketball ahead for us. And what stands out to you, Pelicans, in this one?
It's been about the effort. Love the hustle they did in the first.
Yeah, working hard, really masking some of their weak, piling up second chance points.
So for New Orleans right now, Holiday and Evans are the one and the two. Hill is out there with Terrence Jones. It's Ashik in at the center position. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
And look at that move by Cousins. Love to watch him play with a little misstep. Oh, he takes it to the bucket. And one thing, Gay, is that you know what he's going to give you each game. The more reliable scores in this league.
The free throw drops for Cousins. And Chris, for Rudy Gay, he's reliable. Game to game as a scorer.
And you sure can't overstate how important that is to a team. You always want to have someone that can get buckets every night. Rudy Gay has been that guy his whole life.
And he can't hit the... Pelicans leading by 8. Keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
You guys, we've seen DeMarcus Cousins become one of the elite big men in the NBA, dominant in the post, and even adding a three-pointer to his game. But at times, his temper has overshadowed his talent. Cousins says he's now turned a corner, saying, "My mind has grown. I understand the league better. I understand the politics of it. Now I'm becoming the professional I need to be. It took time." Guys, he understands he now has to lead by example.
He wants to win, David. We know that. Thank you. Jones for 3. The kick out to Hill. Holiday, the pass to Evans. New Orleans moving the ball around. They get it back. Jones. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a three-point play.
Oh, and the focus Jones has, I mean, even when he's getting hit, he possesses the necessary strength to bury these shots.
Pelicans shooting their first free throw attempt on the night. That one misses for Jones.
Now here's Terrence Jones out of Kentucky. A little undersized as a power forward, but boy, you love his skill set. Very smooth with the shot and up fakes underneath. He can go right around defenders with his quickness on the bounce.
Just a terrific effort on the offensive glass. That's how they're going to cut into this lead.
And Greg, a dunk like that is sure to give them a spark. And with Terrence Jones, Chris, he knows how to use his speed and quickness on offense, but he does have trouble slowing up opposing bigs.
And some say that's what's limiting Jones right now in his career. He's shown he can be a versatile scorer as a starter or even off the bench for a team. But some say his inability to defend is keeping him from huge minutes.
Alexis Ajinsa has checked in for Jones. And both free throws good for Evans. We're closing in on 2 minutes played here in the second quarter. And Cousins throws it down.
Oh, I love to see the selfishness from Collison. Really whips the ball over to the open man quickly.
New Orleans leading by 6. Feeds it to Ush. Outside Hill. And stolen by Gabe. Here we go, one-on-one. And Ushik sends it back. Wow! And he's able to get it back. And Collison gets it to go on the assist by Rudy Gay. Collison's got his second bucket of the night. It's deflected and stolen by Coley Stein. Oh, the lob to Collison. It's stolen by Ajinsa. To the paint. Evans kicks to Ajinsa. Knocks it loose. Out of bounds. Sacramento takes possession.
And taking a look here at some numbers for Cousins. Coming off a terrific season, putting in about 27 points a game, 11 rebounds, and 3 assists. And you look at his scoring, he was number one on the team last season.
Aflalo dishes to Collison. And we're now a little over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. It's good, and the New Orleans lead is cut down to 1 on the bucket from Cousins.
And Cousins is such an assured shooter. He definitely has a score-first mentality as soon as he gets the rock.
Evans kicks to Ashik. Wants to get it to Hill, and does. Good on the shot.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Outside Collison. And Cousins kicks to Collison. And Coley Stein throws it down.
Wow, at 7 feet tall, Coley Stein is a major threat to throw it down. If he gets the ball close to the rim, the D is pretty much toast.
Here's Evans. That one's not going to go. Excellent D there from Aflalo. And there's the feed to Coley Stein. Gets it alive, and Gabe with the second chance points. Gabe's got his first bucket of the night.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range. And guys, that's his game. I mean, battling in the paint and cashing in on those second chance opportunities.
And Greg, cashing in hard. I mean, man, oh man, he puts an exclamation point on that dunk.
Yes. But guys, the defense knows he has this ability, correct? Yet no one thinks to put a body on him? Incredible.
Now here's Coley Stein. He's coming off a 19-point game against the Raptors in Toronto.
But it didn't deter him from attacking defensively. His pressure was terrific. He also got 3 steals in that game.
Ajinsa with the bucket. The Kings trail by 3. Outside Collison. Pass to Cousins. Got it for his 4th field goal of the game on just 5 shots.
He's nailing a lot of his attempts right now. This might end up being a big game for him.
Here's Holiday. No good off the back of the rim. For the New Orleans Pelicans, their last game a loss to Golden State.
Yeah, major problems at the charity stripe in that game. They just could not convert their free throws.
And on the road, you're missing your freebies. How do you expect to come out of that scenario with the win?
6 on the shot clock, and it's Aflalo penetrating. Chris, throughout your career, you spent a lot of time down low on the blocks, and we're seeing less of that now, those post-ups that were such a primary option when you played in teams' offenses. Does that concern you? Is that good or bad?
It's concerning from this point. Kids aren't being properly coached. in the middle school and the high school level. Kids don't know how to play on the post. When you look back through the history of this game, whether it's been guards or big fellas, the post is not about how tall you are. The post is about how the closer you are to the basket, you usually have an advantage. And if you have game, then that pump fake game down there will work and get you to the foul line. And if you are a good passer, then it draws the double team. It changes the angle that the defense has to look inside and play. It helps slow the pace down sometimes in the playoffs when the game gets tough and a little bit more physical. And we can say that everybody's changed their game, but only one team wins a year. So, you know, I don't know if the trend is necessarily not there with big guys not in the post when I look at guys like Drummond, Blake Griffin, Dwight Howard, Horford, Jordan, Z-Bo, the Gasol brothers. There's still a lot of post players out there, so I don't subscribe to that opinion that it's less on the post. I just subscribe to the opinion that maybe coaches don't want to coach that way because guys have post game. And we just have to see if the game will change. The small ball right now is what everybody loves.
Great perspective. Six changes of the lead here.
Yeah, both teams still kind of feeling their way through this game.
Now, the Kings haven't had too many deep runs in the playoffs, but they have had some fantastic players over the years. Ever since their move to Sacramento in 1985, they've had some of the most exciting talent in the league. I give credit to the arms of Colley Stein. They go on forever, which makes him the ultimate alley-oop finisher.
Pelicans trail by three. And Holiday kicks to Ajinsa. There's the pick. Passes it to Evans. A 15-footer. And it's Ajinsa missing. And Chris, I would agree that most fans would call you the greatest Sacramento King ever to play.
Well, you know, we've had some great players. And Oscar Robertson wasn't in that Sacramento era. I'm lucky for that because he's one of the greatest players of all time. And you can also make a case for Mitch Richmond. His teams didn't win, but he was an incredible scorer.
Here's what Sacramento's going with right now. Kufis checked in for Cousins. Then McLemore comes in for Aaron Aflalo. And it's Lawson in for Darren Collison. And then for New Orleans, Quincy Pondexter, who's checked in for Hill. Heald comes in for Tyreke Evans. And Langston Galloway subbed in for Drew Holiday. Caspi, he's checked in for the Kings. Barnes comes in for Rudy Gay. Now here's Heald, guarded by McLemore. Ajinsa the pass to Ashik. There's the pick. He kicks it to Galloway. Goes back up. And it's Ajinsa missing.
He's really had a rough quarter on the offensive side of the floor.
Caspi. Second chance shot. And there's the nice layup by Barnes. Barnes has got 6 points.
They are just killing him on the interior.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Pass to Ashik. There's Galloway. 8 points his last outing. He was all alone on that one. Ajinsa's got 6 points in the quarter.
Just a major size difference between the defender and shooter on that possession.
Well, when you get buckets, you have great recognition. And that was great recognition right there by him to see he had a mismatch. He exploited it flawlessly.
Chris, who was your toughest matchup when you were playing? For either the offensive or defensive side of things?
Oh, they were tough matchups every night. I remember a couple of seasons I really had fun playing for Sacramento when just in the West Coast on a nightly basis, the power forwards were Dirk Nowitzki, Tim Duncan, Kevin Garnett, Rasheed Wallace, Brian Grant, and all these guys were in their prime. So I just remember having to be prepared every night and, you know, in the league, there are no tough opponents because it's tough.
Yes.
Period. You know, you can't sleep on anybody in this league.
Well said. Heald can't hit.
He had all the room in the world to get that up, but somehow blew it by rushing it just a tad.
McLemore, no good. Pelicans trail by three. Galloway kicks to Davis. That's good, and so Galloway with the assist. Galloway has got 3 assists tonight.
such a strong finisher on the fast break.
When he has the ball in his hands in transition, he always finishes strong, just like he did there.
Now here's Heald. He hasn't scored yet. That I'm sure will change. Out of bounds, Sacramento takes possession. And now it's a look at the 2K leaderboard with the list of the NBA's best fast break teams from a season ago. Fifth best, the Kings.
I mean, it's a crowd-pleasing style, right? I mean, this club just got out and ran at every possible chance.
Now Lawson. After the missed three from Buddy Heald, Lawson dishes to Casper. Back to Lawson. Down low. Wants to get it to Barnes and does. A lot of post players, Chris, can rely on their strength to score, but others just take you apart with their moves. Who do you feel are some of the smoothest post scorers in the game right now?
Oh, wow. Some of the smoothest post scorers. I still think you got to go to Boogie Cousins in Sacramento. His game and his footwork is just impeccable. Also, how about that jump hook of Pau Gasol? Still so effective even this many years later. And then don't forget about LaMarcus Aldridge. I mean, his jump shot allows for him to use his quickness because guys have to get up on him, and he just plays defenses at his mercy.
Good point. That free throw missing.
And they're having a lot of trouble at the line today, and unfortunately, it's the kind of day we've seen this team have a lot.
Jones checked in for the Pelicans. Good on the second free throw. There's Galloway. Outside, Davis.
Yo, watch it. Hey, yo, right here.
They set the pick. He feeds it to Pondexter. And stolen by Lawson. And here we go, Lawson heading to the hoop. Teardrop shot. Moves back up. And the layup is up and in. Lawson's got six.
And without looking at the scoreboard, you think they were the team trailing and trying to fight their way back.
Pondexter, that's good, and so Galloway with the assist.
And they've had assists now in their last three baskets.
Sacramento's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. Now Lawson. He has six. Over to the left wing. And McLemore kicks to Barnes, launches a three. A shot, no good. And New Orleans will go the other way with it. And guys, this is the first they're seeing of Sacramento.
And they swept the season series against them last year. They really did have the upper hand.
And we'll take a look here at the shot chart.
And as this chart shows, things just aren't falling for him like they usually do. He isn't ice cold, but nothing is falling his way, and he's become an inefficient source of points for his team.
Gentlemen, two shots. Blue shots.
And that one falls for Jones.
And Kings head coach David Yeager did not spend much time unemployed after parting ways with the Grizzlies. I think he was hoping for a new setting with more support from the front office. There have been some friction there in Memphis.
And it's tied up with that one. And you mentioned Yeager looking for a more supportive front office, Chris. Doesn't that make the Kings kind of a surprising choice?
Ah, excellent point, my friend. They've gone through about a coach a year for the last decade. You got a pretty big pay raise, though, and a multi-year commitment. The Kings are lucky to have them. You hope they show some patience.
Now, here's McLemore. That is in there. Lawson with the assist. Lawson's got three assists now in this one. 1:49 left here in the second. Galloway kicks to Davis. He dishes it to Heald. And they wasted no time getting those 3 points back. Heald's got the game tied up here for the Pelicans. Here's Lawson. Blanketed by the D. He fights to the rim for the layup. Lawson's got eight.
Nice work on the inside. Hard to get that one up and over the big fella.
Strong fundamentals right there. He didn't consider the height disadvantage too long. Instead, he just went right at him and sunk it in his grill, in the face.
Kicks it to McLemore. And he didn't get quite enough under that one. New Orleans gone 1-6 from three-point land in the second quarter. Less than 20%, but they've continued to let him fly. Sacramento's gone 2-4 from three-point range so far in the second quarter. Here is Caspi. He's guarded by Davis. And McLemore kicks to Lawson. No good on the three.
And on an open look like that, he's very gifted at making the weak coverage pay.
And there's the pass to Galloway.
I'm open.
We've got 22 seconds left in the first half of the game. That gives them the lead. 7 points in the game. Guys, what a tight start to the game this has been.
And it's still in the first half. This could be a wild one.
And here's Lawson. He's got eight. Shot from free throw range, and that's not going to go. And we're through the first half of basketball here, and what's been a good one. Pelicans ahead. They're up by one. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. Here with Coach Dave Yeager. Coach, what is going to be the focus offensively going into the second half?
Well, we try to go inside. You know, that's our strength anyways. For us, you know, our bread is buttered inside, so we try to play high-low. And then if the threes come out of that, great, but we want to try to get everything to the rim.
Coach, it all starts with that entry pass to the big, and then everybody plays off of him. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, folks. Welcome back. Ernie Johnson here with Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. This is the halftime show on 2K Sports. A tremendous game we're seeing from Anthony Davis. He had 14 points, 6 rebounds, and 1 steal. Kenny, your thoughts, how the Pelicans are playing.
So far, I love their commitment on the glass. Even when they were playing well, their rebounding remained a priority. And so far, the other side hasn't matched their efforts.
Shaq, what's your take on Sacramento?
Their three-point shooting in the first half was atrocious. Ugh, ugly, awful, nasty. It's not that they're just missing shots. It's like they just keep taking the shots. Hold on, Ernie. Hey, you! Whatever your number is, stop shooting the three! See, Ernie, that's all the coach got to do. Tell them stop shooting the three. Pass, cut, work together, do something.
That, sadly, wraps up the halftime show.
No.
The third quarter set to begin in just a few. We'll see you right here, though, after the game, so you have that to look forward to.
Kenny had so much more to say.
And now the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters. You look at DeMarcus Cousins in this game, he has been everywhere.
Always been a dynamic scorer, and we saw in that first half the entire repertoire on display.
That's just an amazing skill set, plus the great instincts, knows intuitively how to get himself open.
The Kings trailing. Gay and Cauley-Stein fill up the forward spots. Collison is out there with a flawless. And it's Cousins in at the pivot, manning the middle. That's the five out there for the Kings. Now here's Gay. Cauley-Stein passes to Gay. Count the bucket, coming off a perfectly placed assist. Gay's got the first basket of the second half. That one for Sacramento. And Holiday kicks to Davis. From 18 feet away, and it's good off the back of the rim and in. Davis has got 16 points. And not even three quarters out of the way. So many lead changes.
The fans, guys, are getting their money's worth. Heck, I should have paid to watch this one. It's been a nail biter.
And even three-on-three break. He can't get it to go. And the Kings going the other way now. They'll face the Lakers after this one. That'll be at home. And that game is the second of two straight at home. Well for New Orleans, shooting pretty well at 46% from the floor. Evans kicks to Hill. Teardrop shot. And Evans the basket on the assist by Hill. And now a three-point New Orleans lead. The Kings have gone 1-3 since starting the second half. Collison kicks to Gay. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Gay's got his third basket of the night right there.
The scoring skills of Gay aren't just limited to the mid-range and his perimeter. This is a guy who can get it done from the inside as well, thanks to his fantastic length.
A follow outside. It's stolen by Hill. Evans outside. It's back to Hill. Outside, Davis. New Orleans moving the ball around. Six on the shot clock. And here's Evans outside. And another three for New Orleans.
Yeah, the D with very little pressure on their perimeter shooters. Three of the last five baskets they've allowed have been from beyond.
Now here's Collison. He's got five. Game with it. A fader. And off the glass. That one's good. Gay's got six here in this quarter.
And Gay is very confident from the mid-range. When he has his feet under him, he's extremely reliable from there.
One item with Rudy Gay, Chris, is that he is very aware how to take advantage of a mismatch.
And that awareness, Kev, is something that has made Gay such a reliable scorer. A lot of players have one way that they prefer to get buckets. But Gay is comfortable doing whatever it takes. He's gotten better over his career and taking what the defense gives him.
Now here's Cauley Stein, following the shot by Drew Holiday. Here's Collison. Can't tie it up as that one's no good. The Pelicans have gone 3-5 to start the second half, developing a nice rhythm out there. Evans dishes to Holiday. It's taken away by Collison. And now, in transition, it's a follow. Here we go. And we've got a moment now to look at the highest scoring teams in the NBA from last season. The Kings in third.
I just loved how this team attacked their opponents. You could see their confidence grow as the year went on, and the points really started to pile up.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
He misses the free throw. And the second free throw, good. Now here's Evans. 12 points for him. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the third quarter. Hill passes to Holiday. Ashik with a screen on Collison. And Holiday, here we go. And that's out of bounds. New Orleans will retain possession. Alexis Ajinsa has checked in for New Orleans. And so it's New Orleans with it. Down to five on the shot clock. And again, no good by New Orleans.
If he can find himself out there, his team will be in fantastic shape to get this win.
And Cauley Stein throws it down. A great competitive game so far.
And from the look of it, this one could go right down to the wire.
The Pelicans trail. And Holiday kicks to Evans. Down low, Ajinsa. Sacramento grabs the miss. Cauley-Stein's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Gay with no one around. Here's Cousins, and Cousins throws it down.
Great hustle from Cousins there. He never stops working on that offensive glass.
They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
And yes, it's good. 6 points for Hill. For Sacramento, they've gone 5 of 9 on field goal attempts since halftime. Holiday against Collison. Gay dishes to Cousins. And they double up Cousins. D2 from Collison. The offensive rebound. Here's Cauley-Stein. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot 2.
Oh, man. Cauley-Stein is just a workhorse down inside. And because of his efforts, he earns a lot of tough foul calls in the process.
He's getting his first free throw attempt of the night right now.
2 shots.
No good on that one.
Now, Willie Cauley-Stein was considered a bit of a reach for his draft position, but you have to love how he plays at his size. Very active inside with his feet to flash open on cuts. Just shows great awareness for a new player in the league.
And they call over the back here. Too much contact.
You know, right call. Gave the officials no choice there. I mean, they've got to make that call over the back.
When you think of Cauley-Stein, the word length comes to mind. A huge target on offense and a tenacious shot blocker and rebounder on the defensive end.
Well, you hate to use the P word, potential, but you can't help but do it with Willie Cauley-Stein.
You're right, Kev. I hate the word potential as well. It just means unrealized talent. As long as he moves as well as he does with his size, he'll be fine. A frustrating start to this quarterfinal.
And Cousins kicks to Cauley-Stein. On the wing, Aflalo, covered by Evans. Aflalo, no good.
It's not winning basketball when you're attempting shots like that.
Oh, no, you're right. It's selfish on his part to attempt that. Should have passed it back out and tried to get a better look.
Evans kicks to Ajinsa. Yes, and a nice assist from Evans. Ajinsa's got 12 points in the game.
David versus Goliath, except this time, the bigger man wins this one.
Here's Collison. And Ushik sends it back. Wow! Evans, that's a 2-pointer. Pelicans keep it alive. The Kings trailing. Here's Cousins, and 2 shots coming up at the line as he gets fouled on the shot. And New Orleans gets called for the foul.
When Cousins has the rock inside, he's ridiculously efficient. He just has such power when he has the ball down low.
This will be his 5th trip to the free throw line.
Shooting 2.
And that one falls for DeMarcus Cousins. So he hits 1 of 2 from the stripe.
Nice. Tying it up, though a little disappointed that he couldn't give him the lead.
And good that time.
And since halftime, he has been a different player.
So it's Sacramento. Outside Collison. Gay outside. Now the dish to Cauley-Stein. And Cauley-Stein throws it down.
And guys, right now, the defense mentally not there. Can't afford too many of those in a close game like this.
Yeah, Jay, you're right. Almost a free run for him there.
Well, yeah, and you have to give him credit, too. Makes the right read go straight to the rim.
and good passing setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Outside Collison. Dishes to Cousins. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
And the bruising game of Cousins, nearly impossible to match up with him given his massive size.
He shot 10 free throws tonight. He's made six of them.
And would love to hear a little more swish and a lot less clang from the charity stripe.
And that one falls for Cousins. A big group substitution here for Sacramento. Kufis checked in for Willie Cauley-Stein. Barnes comes in for Rudy Gay. Ben McLemore, he's checked in for Aaron Aflalo. And Ty Lawson subbed in for Darren Collison. A big group substitution here for New Orleans. Terrence Jones has checked in for Alexis Ajinsa. Pondexter comes in for Solomon Hill. Heald's checked in for Tyreek Evans. And Langston Galloway subbed in for Drew Holiday. Now here's Ashik. At the top of the key, Galloway. In the corner, it's Pondexter. And stolen by Barnes. Here's Lawson. Ashik pulls it in. Ashik's got 9 rebounds now tonight. Pondexter from outside. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. Here's McLemore. 5 points in the game. The shot's good from Lawson.
And the recognition of McLemore, a team-oriented player who is always looking to dish the rock.
Here's Galloway. Lawson defending. Goes up and lays it nice and easy. And so here's Sacramento. It's a 1-point game. Feeds it to Kufis. Inside. McLemore, no good.
They look to him to bury those kinds of shots, even with the D all over him.
It's up a 3. Galloway with the bucket. Galloway has got 5 points in the quarter. And not even 3 quarters out of the way. So many lead changes.
The fans, guys, are getting their money's worth. Heck, I should have paid to watch this one. It's been a nail bite.
Now here's Lawson. He's got 11. Now the feed to Barnes. Down low. Here's Cousins. Gets the bucket and the foul. That's on Terrence Jones.
Oh, and Cousins just has the mentality that no one can stop him. Even when he gets hit, he has the talent to brush it off and still nail the shot.
On the night, shooting 8 of 12 from the line. New Orleans has gone into the 3-point range 4 times since halftime and buried 2 of them. 3-pointer, Pondexter. It's hauled in by the Kings. Kufis has got 4 rebounds now tonight. To the middle. It's tipped. It's stolen by Jones. Here's Galloway. That one a little long. The Kings leading. And now the Kings fast break. And the dunk by Barnes.
Wow, the floor just really opened up for him on that possession.
Well, of course it did. The D was nowhere to be found. And because of that, he easily sprinted down the court and got an easy bucket over there.
Here's Galloway. He has 7. Pass to Heald. To the inside. Jones. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for 2. And here is the shot chart as we see how things are going.
And the 3-point game stands out as a major sore spot. It just has not been falling for him. I think at this point you start to get away from that shot. Try to engage in other parts of the offense. You don't want to hurt your team if that long ball isn't there.
And the first one drops.
In the former Wildcat, Jones is an effective two-way player, an outstanding defender, who also possesses a nice touch from outside.
And the Kings making a change here. Caspi's checked in. And so Jones nails both of them. Sacramento's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Lawson kicks to Kufis. And he makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
Oh, going high
to throw that one down.
Sky high. Fantastic one-hand jam. Passes it to Jones. To the middle. Good D by Barnes. Kings leading now by three. Watson the pass to Caspi. From deep, McLemore. Another three for Sacramento.
Three-point shooting since the half has been about as good as you could ask for.
Galloway kicks to Pondexter. Pass to Jones. They set the screen. Here's Galloway. No good off the front iron.
The defense got super lucky there because he does not miss many of those.
Guys, they've been getting it done.
They came out with a mission, and they have been tough to stop.
And stolen by Kufis. Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge's reporting from the sidelines.
Well, Kevin, smartphones and other technology are ubiquitous nowadays. Clippers head coach Doc Rivers says teams do pay a price. Social media and texting has absolutely hurt chemistry, he said. He recalled his championship season with the Celtics. One of the best things that happened to them was during the preseason in Italy. The players couldn't get a wireless signal, and they had to actually talk with one another. Kevin?
Yeah, that connection between players can make a difference. Thanks, David. Lawson dishes to Barnes. Launches a three. No good from Lawson.
The defense took a big risk leaving him wide open and got lucky. He clanked that outside shot.
Kicks to heel. He feeds it to Pondexter. Some nice passing here by New Orleans. To the paint. Kufis grabs the miss. Kufis has got 7 rebounds in the game. The drive by Barnes. And he gets the bucket. Barnes has got the lead up to 8 now for Sacramento.
And after really leaning on that three-point shot in the first half, seeming like they're just getting away from it here in the second. More of the shots coming from the interior.
Now here's Heald. He's guarded close. A second chance effort. Kufis with the block. McLemore. That shot is off. And we've watched 3 so far in this one. Kings lead by 8. And after a quick break, we're going to come right back with the start of the fourth quarter. Let's take a listen now to Alvin Gentry.
Guys, we got to be more solid, okay? We got to be more solid defensively. Now, we got to dig in, we got to guard, okay? And then we got to execute our offense.
A lot of things on that list, trying to refocus his troops moments ago, Coach Alvin Gentry.
Yeah, the energy's all right, but the execution definitely could be better with and without the basketball.
And the final period of play just about to start. Here's Evans on the court for the Pelicans, getting the fourth quarter going. Holiday and Evans are the 1 and the 2. Terrence Jones out there with Anthony Davis, and it's Hill in at the 3, the small forward. And it's Davis missing. Sacramento leading by 8. Collison the pass to Gay. He kicks it to Casper. A follow outside. Tries again. Crafty move. Caspi with the bucket. Caspi's got the fourth quarter going with the first basket of the period here for the Kings. Evans kicks to Holiday. Evans outside. He dishes it to Davis. And there it is for him.
And after his last game, really not surprised to see him as hot as he is here tonight.
Sometimes you get into a zone for a few games and the basket seems as if it's wide as the ocean.
Here's Collison following the basket by Anthony Davis. There's a screen. Got a piece of it. It's stolen by Davis. Right side Holiday. Here's Jones. Ball's knocked loose. Kings leading now by 8. Here's Collison, and fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot 2. That's on Terrence Jones.
Now, what you have to like about Darren Collison is the fact that he gives you a little bit of everything from the point guard position. He can shoot it from deep. He can attack the basket depending on what the defender gives him. He acts as a true facilitator for the rest of the team when he's manning the point guard.
No good on the free throw. And Chris, with Collison, as you said, he is a jack of all trades as a floor general.
Well, a lot of it is that Collison knows what he can and can't do and plays within himself. Always plays to the tempo of the game.
Catching up on the changes for Sacramento. Cousins comes in for Kufis, and it's Willie Cauley-Stein in for Kasper. And the Pelicans also making a change. Agence's checked in. And he misses the second one as well, so he is 0 for 2 that time.
Whoa. An unfruitful trip to the line. He's typically consistent from there.
And didn't do anything fancy there, but didn't need to.
Nope. His only concern right now is getting the points on the board. And I don't mean style points. Now, here's Collison. And it's Gay at the elbow. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. Such a unique offensive player is Anthony Davis. Maybe not as skilled, perhaps, as Durant, but they both have that elasticity to just stretch out and finish over the top.
And Davis a little bigger, a little stronger than, say, a Durant. More of an interior game. But as he develops, we're seeing him stretch his range out beyond the arc. And for both him and Durant, I don't think you set any limits on what they can do offensively. You just got to give those guys the green light.
And when it comes to athletic small forwards, Gay is the cream of the crop. An aggressive player whose reach really helps him on both offense and defense.
Second free throw, no good. Pelicans trail by 7. Outside Hill. The putback, great positioning on the putback.
That is really good work there on the offensive glass.
Holiday against Collison. Gay kicks to Cauley-Stein. And that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts at the line.
Oh, and it's important for Cauley-Stein's confidence that he gets these interior shots to fall. The more he sees the ball go in, the more assured he will feel down inside.
And that one falls for Cauley-Stein. The Pelicans have gone 3 of 6 from the field so far in the fourth quarter. Evans kicks to Holiday. Davis with a screen on Collison. Holiday dishes to Davis. It's good, the assist that time from Holiday. 22 points for Anthony Davis.
And how about the grit and determination in the post? I mean, essential qualities to have late in a close game.
Now, here's Collison, and there's the pass to Cousins. Now the dish to Gay, and he's good on the three ball. And the Kings lead by 9.
It's really been a tale of two halves, guys. A slow start, but this quarter, he has really been the man.
There's a screen. Hill passes to Davis from about 16. And the shot no good, a bit short. The Kings shooting 53% from the floor. They're locked in. Here's Gay, and the Kings check on 2 more.
And the razor-sharp focus of Gay. Never letting defenders get to him on these shots.
Timeout called here. The Pelicans decide to talk it over. You look at DeMarcus Cousins, what a contribution.
The D has no answer for him inside, and they better figure him out soon if they want to win this one.
And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, I was able to listen in on what Alvin Gentry said to his team. and he was emphatic. He said, we are not going to win this game playing this way, fellas. You've got to step it up. You've got to get aggressive, and you've got to battle to get back in this thing. See if that pep talk got him going, guys.
Thank you, David. Now here's Davis. Outside Hill. Agenza kicks to Hill. He gets that one.
You always hear about chemistry. That's a perfect example, knowing where each other is at all times.
Here's Collison. Cauley Stein. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points. Cauley Stein's got the lead up to 11 now for Sacramento.
Oh, man, the relentless pursuit of the basketball by Cauley Stein. Just a tremendous hustler on the offensive glass.
Here's Davis. And that shot misses everything. Air ball on the three. Kings leading now by 11. Deflects the pass. And for the ball out of bounds, Davis touched it last.
Well, close to picking that one off.
Oh, he gets a great jump on it. Barely bounces off his fingertips.
And the Pelicans making a change here. Ashik's checked in. Now here's Cousins. Gay outside. Dishes it to Cauley Stein. Feeds it to Aflalo. Five to shoot. Step back shot. A shot that time, not on target. Evans with some nice D.
Well, he's still trying to find a shot out there, but so far he hasn't hit anything from the field.
And the rejection by Cousins.
And one of the things Cousins has continued to develop, his defense. Really makes an effort to swat that shot away.
That free throw, no good. Good on the second free throw. Sacramento leading by 10. Now Aflalo. The feed to Collison. Back to Aflalo. Deflects the pass. Ashik with it. Guarded now by DeMarcus Cousins. And the rejection by Cousins. And here's Collison. Pass to Cousins.
Come to me.
Here's Gay. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
Oh, man. Over the years, Gay has really perfected his shot fake. Defenders have a tough time not falling for it.
Take a break. Two shots.
And he knocks down the first one. And so Gay nails both of them.
After being a little hesitant in the first, he looked much more intent on getting himself to the strike.
Outside Holiday. The high post shot. And Willie Cauley Stein gets the whistle that time. That's his third foul of the game. And the Pelicans with possession here. And Cousins comes over to help. Some nice passing here by New Orleans. And Holiday kicks to Davis. Five to shoot. But he gets it back. They grab their own miss. Evans. And finally they hit one.
Well, that's the range you want to shoot it from if you can get there.
Sacramento leading by 8. outside Collison. And finished off by Gay.
Oh, man, the dunks that Gay flushes home are what he's best known for, a relentless athlete. He just flat out gets it done.
New Orleans has gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Davis sets a screen. Shoots from 12. That doesn't go either for Davis. For Sacramento, they've gone 6 of 9 on their field goal attempts since the start of the fourth quarter. And it's good for 2.
I love the killer instinct he shows right there, exploding to the rim to add to the lead.
No mercy. He's one of the best at slamming the door shut in the opposition's face when they're trying to come back.
Now here's Davis. Shoots from 12. Misses off the right iron. A follow outside. Passes it to Gay. Ollie Stein in the post. He's guarded by Davis. Here's Collison. And there are the Kings with another bucket.
Even when the defense is all over him, Collison just uses his quick release so well when he's operating down low.
Pass to Holiday. Evans outside. Kicks it to Ush. Inside. Here's Holiday. And the shot is good, dropping in off the front of the rim.
It really does make the game easy for your teammates when you can lead them to the rim that well with a pass.
They set the pick. Here's a follow. The shot's good. Collison making the play. Collison's got his 9th assist in the game now.
Those defenders just look a little bit gassed. I mean, they're getting pushed around on that low block.
Now here's Evans. Shot clock at 5. Hill up top. That's good. Basket number 5 on a 5-for-8 night shooting.
Even though he has been a man on a mission on offense, he still hasn't been able to help his team get the lead.
Gay outside.
And really, these are some of the toughest calls an official has to make.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
First free throw is good. Heels checked in for Tyreek Evans. Off on that one, so he goes 1-for-2 at the line. It's getting harder and harder to become an NBA owner. Franchise values are skyrocketing. The league, Chris, as you know, has set limits on how many minority owners a team can have. 25 per team is the number. They each have to own at least 1%.
Well, you know, there's only 30 of them, and the chance to make your impact on a franchise is just tremendously exciting. You know, we've seen in the past years where ownership groups could become very fragmented, so I definitely understand that train of thought.
Great perspective. Kings leading now by 13. To the middle, here's Cousins. And then Cousins with the dunk.
Oh, when Cousins finds his comfort zone, it's incredibly hard for the defense to keep up with him.
Davis in the corner, puts up a 3. No good on that one. And for the Kings, they're shooting 55% from the floor. They're feeling very confident offensively. Hill dishes to Holiday. And there's the foul, and Darren Collison picks it up. That's foul number 2 for him.
Timeout.
Timeout called here. The Pelicans decide to talk it over.
Yeah, enough scoring on the inside there. I think it's time for him to send a message to his team.
Oh, well, they have to become more physical defensively and really commit to protecting that painted area.
Davis sets a screen. Jacks up a three. Ashik, the pass to Holiday. He feeds it to Davis. Davis with a screen on Gay. Hill kicks to Heald. Lets the three fly. Good, and it's Hill picking up the assist. 6 points for Buddy Heald.
And that's what happens when you have little to no communication defensively. He has the stroke to burn you from out there. Don't you see that?
A one-man show offensively, and that's almost always good news for his team.
Pelicans trailed by 14. Down low, here's Davis, and he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. Davis has got 12 points in just the second half. Here's Cauley Stein, and so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
Well, that's the length of Cauley Stein. He's a nuisance for any opponent. He uses that to his advantage in how he draws fouls.
And that one misses. He hits the second from the line. Pelicans trail by 13. Holiday with it. Screen by Ashik. And Holiday kicks to Davis. To the middle. And Cousins comes over to help. There's the pass to Ashik. Collison against Holiday. Gay dishes to Cousins. Drives from the block, and there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line.
I mean, even from over here, you could see that one pretty clearly.
First one at the line is good. Steph Curry, the first unanimous MVP winner last season, Chris. I heard it suggested that former MVPs should get a vote on who wins the award. Would you agree?
Yeah, I agree with that, of course. I agree that players should vote most of the time because they're really out there on the floor and they get to see the nuances and intangibles of the game that we don't get to see. And I also have another idea for All-Star. How about this, Kevin? Three-point shooting contest. After we have the winner of the three-point shooting contest with NBA players only, then the next day we come back and we have the winner go against the former winner. You know, just think about seeing Larry Bird out there, Craig Hodges out there, Vashawn Leonard out there.
Yes.
Oh, Steve Kerr out there. You know, I'd love to see it because one thing about basketball, it transcends everything, including age. And the jump shot never gets old. I'd love to see that.
Great perspective. And it's Davis missing. And the Kings shooting has been just great so far, up at 56%.
And there's no doubt about this one. Playing with a lot of confidence tonight. It's a statement victory for the Kings.
In the end, they had a better shooting percentage, and that's what made the difference. Sometimes, you know, things go your way. The other team wasn't catching any lucky breaks themselves.
Yeah, and Kevin, not all about luck. I thought their overall shot selection was better.
And it'll mark their fourth win on the year. Actually, their fifth win on the year.
And this is a great way for them to kick off this season series. Two more games ahead, and they've taken the mental advantage with this win tonight. And beyond the actual result of this game, fans are going to look back and see this was just a monstrous performance for DeMarcus Cousins.
He was in attack mode for entire game. There was no sitting back. He was going to take it to him every chance he got. And they love when he plays with that kind of aggressive mindset.
The free throw off from Rudy Gay. Heald kicks to Pondexter. Gay with the block.
And Gay has put a ton of work into his defense over the years, specifically how he times blocking those shots.
Ajinsa misses there. And so it's Sacramento easily grabbing this one. A confident win and one where they clearly showed the greater effort.
Yeah, I mean, it was a solid performance, particularly here at home. And I think they built off that edge of being here and play with just a little more confidence than their opponent.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, Darren. You guys were down by double digits. What did Coach say to get you guys back in the game?
Well, good teams don't lose their poise. You know, you understand that sometimes there are going to be games like this, but the most important thing is we just got to get the win.
And you wound up with the win. Congratulations. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And that'll do it, folks. For Chris Weber, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thank you for being with us. And as the fans file out of the building, now time to head over to Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, and Kenny the Jet Smith for the post-game show.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
And Ernie Johnson here again with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith. Without further ado, let's present our Jordan player of the game, DeMarcus Cousins.
I don't think anyone has come as far since entering the league as DeMarcus has. Now tonight, we saw what a force he's become in the low post. He got all the moves, got the attitude. Just a tremendous competitor. And he's got cool hair, too. Not that I'm looking, but it just looks pretty cool.
He just put on a clinic. That's the kind that makes you want to just take notes. Like, grab your pad, make notes, because you're never going to see something like this again, possibly. Combining an elite skill set with an intact first mindset. Wow, incredible.
And that is the end of our broadcast for this evening. It sounds like an old 1940s guy, don't I? That's the end of our broadcast for this evening.
Kenny, Ernie, join me.
For Ken Smith and Shaq O'Neal.
Join me.